Foreign Resources is a company. It's the third of two great successes we've had. It's actually probably going to be the most exciting one that I've ever seen or to be a luxury to be part of in my last 18 years in the business, as we're about to undertake the world's largest discovery drill program for gold in the next 6 months in a condensed period of time. With that being said, I will be making some forward-looking statements just because we are excited and some of these projects have some very big potential. So our theme at Auren is maximum reward with minimum risk. And how do we do that? We do that through a portfolio approach, where we're different than most other juniors that have exploration portfolios, multiple properties, is ours is live, meaning we're going to drill our entire portfolio in the next 6 months. The experience behind us is not just technical, but it's also financial and corporate. We've been able to find gold mines, we've been able to sell companies, and we've been able to deliver tremendous value for our shareholders in that, and you'll see it here in just a few slides. I've underlined the exceptional technical team. Those of you who are not familiar with us, we were fortunate enough to attract Newmont's global exploration team in the downturn. So we're a junior resource company with a majors exploration team in it, and none of the red tape that would go with that. And lastly, really it is about the efficiency and discovery capital being spent. We're spending about $36 million in the ground this year from January till December. $4 million will go towards G&A and marketing ourselves, but think about that as a shareholder. 90% of our treasury goes into the ground. It's real money to go find major gold mines. So this is a bit of our past successes that we've had. We've raised $500 million as needed. We've never had an issue raising money. Our first company was called Keegan Resources. It's our second best success, where we created a producing mining company from a discovery from 0 to 5 million ounces, and then we acquired 5 more. It's a 10 million ounce company that trades on the NYSE as well as the Toronto Stock Exchange. But again, that's our second best success that we've had. Caden was our first best success, or the best success you could have. We sold a junior exploration company in the middle of the bear market for $205 million. Tremendous share price appreciation in a time when nobody was making money on resource stocks. There was no resource, no official deposit in Caden, and that was kind of the wizardry of what we're taking on with Auren. But we're taking what we learned in both Keegan, which is now Asanko Gold, and in Caden, we're putting it into Auren to do something even better that's never been done before. This here is a slide representing of exactly why I'm standing here today, not because this is our resume of our first two companies, but we're showing you the discovery curve as it existed for Keegan in the last bull market, 49 cents to $9 per share. That's the discovery of a 5 million ounce gold deposit in Ghana. And then we're showing you in the middle of the bear market, a discovery that was underway 100 drill holes where the stock went from 67 cents and we sold it at 350 per share, which has gone up since because we took Agnico shares. That multiple, those returns, we're taking 25 shots at finding something like this in the next 6 months in Auren. That's how big Auren can be going forward this year. So this live portfolio approach, there's 7 major projects. There's 3 in Canada. They're all high grade. And then there's 4 down in Peru. Peru is all oxide. The most profitable types of metal you can mine or find are high grade gold or oxide gold with infrastructure. And we have both of those in our portfolio. The odds is always against you in the exploration business, but we have enough projects that will reduce the risk significantly. The more shots you take, the better chance you have of hitting. We're taking 25 major shots from June of this year till December of this year. We own 100% of everything, or we have the option to earn 100%. So we have ownership of everything. So if we find something, we get to reap the full reward. Moving on, our capital share structure, 76 million shares out. A couple notable things on this slide is our shareholders, not only our existing retail shareholders who followed us from our previous successes, but Goldcorp became a shareholder in January at $3.67 per share. Goldcorp came in at a premium to market. It was a great validation of what we have as a portfolio and what we might be able to find this year. Management owns over 18%. A lot of that was purchased in the public market. And then if you look in the yellow boxes, the last year was predominantly acquisitions. We did about 4 acquisitions last year. This year is going to be all about discovery drilling. This is where you make money as a shareholder. This is why the stock is starting to perform. People are starting to speculate we might make a few major discoveries this year. I won't go into too much detail about ourselves, but I will say we're very balanced. There's people on this slide that are from the corporate aspect very strong, financially very strong, and technically. And I will say as we build these companies, we inhabit more and more better people along the way. Great management teams draw great people. The world-class technical team, this is something we're very proud of. If you look through this list or go to our website, you can read more about them. But what makes this different from most juniors, even most majors, it's deeper by depth of amount of people on this page, as well as people that aren't on this page. A lot of them are former global experts from Newmont, including the former chief geologist of Newmont, Antonio Rivas, or Rael Lipson, the former chief geologist of Goldfields. So these are really, really, really highly experienced, intelligent experts that have come together as a team to help us define this portfolio so everything we're looking for is of the magnitude that would impress them while they were with the major. Moving ahead, this is a quick snapshot of where we are. Northern Canada, or in Canada, we're in Nunavut with Committee Bay and Gibson's McCoy. We have about 420 kilometers of greenstone belts, a place where a lot of money is being spent. I'll go into it just a moment, and there's some existing resources there already. Homestake Ridge in BC is in a place called the Golden Triangle. Golden Triangle is one of the richest places of endowment in the world for gold mines. There's 1.2 million ounces approximately of gold equivalent in Homestake of 9 grams per ton. That's incredibly high grade. We think that could possibly double or triple on the back of this year's drill program that we're about to undertake. And if you come down to Peru in the southern portion of my map, we're going to say one word for Peru, it's endowment. Everything in Peru is big. Yanacocha, 60 million ounces of gold. Las Bambas was sold in 2014 for $6 billion to MMG by Glencore. There's major discoveries down there, major mines. So we're high grade in the north. We have oxide, scalable, large projects in the south. Here's a quick snapshot. Committee Bay is in yellow at the top. Gibson's McCoy is down to the south. In green, you can kind of see Agnico Eagle is committed to spending $1.2 billion in the Arctic. They said that in Q1 of this year. That's a really tremendous undertaking by them. But they've got a new mine called Amaruq, where in 3 years they got to about 7 million ounces, and it still is getting bigger. They've also got Meliadine. It's about 11 million ounce deposit that they're about to build to go take into production. So Committee Bay, Gibson's McCoy, it's big, it's high grade. We think the frontier for high grade gold discoveries, large ones in the world, will be in the north. This is a quick snapshot of Committee Bay. District grade scale and massive potential for discovery. Those yellow lines are outlining corridors and mineralization. In red, we actually are showing you the top 2% of the entire belt. We were recently marketing in New York, so we show the size of Manhattan of how big some of these corridors are. If you look at the lower right picture, it's the distance from Boston to New York. There's 67 discoveries along this belt prior to us getting this property. Had very no follow-up, very minimal work has been done, and we've taken it to the next level this year as we get ready to drill. This deposit is in the middle of the belt. It's about 1.2 million ounces of 8 grams per ton. We're drawing a white dotted line here in the top 150 meters because the drilling we're going to do this year will only reach 150 meters from surface. We're trying to find the start of two more of these, but if you look at some of the results, 14 of 7 grams, 12 of 15 grams, 39 of 12 grams, if you start to see that come out of our summer drill programs that start in about 2 weeks from now, that's going to mean we're on to something big that could be like an Amaruq or another Three Bluffs. That's what we're going for. We're taking 12 shots at finding 12 Amaruqs this summer. The infrastructure, that's a big challenge up there. Fortunate for us, there's been $100 million spent, of which $30 million roughly went into the ground of setting up camps. All the heavy equipment, everything you see on this slide, we own except for the 737 aircraft. So we just bring fuel each year. Very turnkey exploration. Now moving over to Homestake Ridge in BC, we're looking at the Golden Triangle. We've got in the yellow blocks there, I don't think I have a laser pointer, but you can see the Homestake Main Zone as well as the Homestake Silver Zone and the South Reef Zone. That's what makes up the 1.2 million ounces of 9 grams gold equivalent. There's a massive VMS SK Creek target. There's obvious deposit extensions to the north and to the south of the main zones and the Silver Zone. And then the South Reef Zone, the Vanguard Trend. It's about 6 kilometers long, 3 to 20 grams gold taken in rock samples, barely even touched with the drill bit. So this year will be about unlocking the triangle. And if we can get to 2 or 3 million ounces of 9 grams per ton, it'd be a tremendous success for us. One thing we did do here is we unlocked tremendous value with the metallurgy. Before we got this project, they were blending two concentrates. We separated them. We're getting 84% recovery in gold and about 88% in the copper concentrate and about 88% gold recovery in the lead concentrate. There's a road that goes to Deepwater Port 7 kilometers away. So the economics of what we've done on the back of the envelope are extremely favorable. It probably costs around $125 million to build. It probably have about 14 months payback and be about a $375 million US NPV as we sit here without finding one more ounce of gold. If we double the gold that's there, we'll be pushing a $1 billion NPV because of how rich it is and how close it is to infrastructure. This is a look at the deposit in gold is the red portion, is outlining the gold portion. Silver is representing the in the blue portion. You can see there's a zonation effect. It goes silver, gold, then you get into gold and copper. To the left side of the screen, you're seeing something called the slide zone, silver slide zone. It goes on for 3 kilometers. We're showing you some core that was drilled at the higher portion of it, but no one drilled deeper to the depth to test the gold target. We think that's very low-hanging fruit to just keep adding deposit towards the south from that portion. Moving down to Peru, the word was endowment. We've listed some of the big mines that have been found in Peru. Sombrero has gotten everyone's attention. It's one of the best projects we've ever seen. This, the whole entire technical team pre-drilling in terms of grade, in terms of endowment potential. It's about 200 kilometers west of Las Bambas. And then we have 3 projects right next to Chile, and we'll talk about those second. The one thing we do get in Peru is excellent infrastructure. There's power lines, water, and roads to each one of our projects. That is incredibly, incredibly opportunistic for profitability because everything here in Peru is from surface, it's open pit, and it's oxide. This is Sombrero, a snapshot of it. What the geologists are showing you here is some of the best or the right ingredients for a major skarn discovery, the limestone, the diorite intrusive, and then they're showing you some of the grades that were taken. There's better grades, there's lower grades, but averaging in the multi-gram and multi-percent copper, those are spectacular grades because they're 200 kilometers west of Las Bambas, which averaged under a gram gold equivalent. So these are obviously much richer, and there's a much bigger gold component here. This is a surface look. It's a bit technical. What we're trying to show you here is that wherever we've gone and taken samples, we're getting a lot of grade, a lot of gold, a lot of copper. No one's ever drilled this before. In the big mines in Peru, these things appear as clusters. You're looking at 2 clusters here. There are 3 more off this page and land that we've just staked, but this certainly has the hallmarking to be something even bigger than what Las Bambas was by structure and by grade. Moving ahead, Baños del Indio and Huiacoyo. This is in the southern portion. To the right of Baños or south of Baños, you're running into a mine called La Coipa, which is operated by Kinross, which is about 7 million ounces of gold. Same steam heated alteration type of system in Baños del Indio. And then Huiacoyo has a nice oxide deposit, top of a hill, barely drilled. What we're trying to show you here is this big north-south structure that connects the two properties. That was critical in Yanacocha. That was the deep-rooted structure that hosted the 60 million ounces of gold. In here, it appears to be the same. Baños del Indio is massive. It's the same scale and size as a La Coipa. But Huiacoyo is the one that has a bit of work on it. And this is what it looks like. You can see in the top box, there's some 80 or so meters of a 1.2 grams per ton. This is oxide, the top of a hill. I'll show it to you in 3D in just a moment. But we did some work in the fall in the bottom square. Everything in pink is really highly anomalous gold from surface. So we did some surface work, huge targets coming out of this project. Infrastructure is our friend. You're mining the top of a hill once you get to deposit. The pink shape would be the actual ore that would get mined. You can see some of the grades that were drilled, but also the trench, 38 meters of almost 7 grams per ton across the structure. That 38 meters of 7 grams per ton is on that north-south structure that goes up to Baños del Indio. So really critical when you look at something from a district or a regional perspective, it certainly has the gold there. It has all the structural components for size, and then it also has the oxide, the power, and the water nearby. Back to my original point, 89% of our treasury goes into exploration and drilling. That number's $36 million this year. This is how we spend our money. We're very proud of this slide as large shareholders of our own company. Gives us the best shot to perform for you guys in the next 6 months. This is our drill program. It starts June 10th, I believe. We'll announce it June 3rd, the exact day that it's going to start. We start in Committee Bay. We actually add more rigs into Homestake in BC, so we'll be drilling both our Canadian projects at the same time. Once those drills are completing, we'll start drilling in Peru. And drilling in Peru, it says plus 5,000 meters. I can tell you from what we've seen so far, we're going to drill a lot more than that in Peru. No, our money does not cover a lot more meters. Would we refinance? We probably would in the late fall on the back of some results out of the drilling in Canada, but money has never been an issue for us. So just to summarize, the opportunity in Orin is unique to itself. The quality and scalability of everything we have, those 25 shots we're taking, those are 25 shots at finding 5 million ounce size deposits. Those are massive or bigger. The experience that we have in doing this, this is our third company that we're doing. We're doing this because there was a big opportunity in the bear market. We had a great success. We went shopping, not just for assets, but for people, and we put together this portfolio where not only do we own the projects, we have a big ownership ourselves, but we have a major who's invested into us, you know, at a premium to market, which is a great validation of what we have. The optionality of a company with multiple projects is quite obvious. We could sell them one at a time. We could sell the whole company as a whole. We think that the scalability of these projects will lead to a transaction much before we get the chance to actually build these things and take them into production. And then lastly, the catalyst. The drill bit, that's how all the money is made. You know, one drill hole can give you a quadruple on your share price. We're drilling about 300 holes this year from June until December across 25 different projects or targets across 7 projects. This is going to be substantial. We're going to have a huge discovery year. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Appreciate your time.